morning, my dear students. So welcome back to your science class. Can you see the board properly and can you hear me properly? Everyone switch off your microphone and camera. Okay, thank you Sanchita. So today I will continue the chapter number 9 and today's topic is some terrestrial habitats. Okay, today I will discuss about the some terrestrial habitats. Now you know that the climate of the terrestrial habitat, or what is the meaning of terrestrial habitat, that is the plants and animals that live on land are said to live in the terrestrial habitat, right? That means the plants and animals that live on the land are said to live in the terrestrial habitat. Now under the terrestrial habitat we will find different types. I can see everyone, can you see me? Then Sanjita, check your internet, okay? You can disconnect the call and again rejoin the call. Maybe this is the problem from your side. So under the terrestrial habitat we will find different types. What are they? Desert, mountain, grassland, forest. Okay, so under the terrestrial habitat some example or some types are desert, mountain, grassland, forest, etc. Okay, first we have to read all this in detail. So today I will start with the desert. Okay, so today I will discuss the desert habitat first, and we will come to know that the different plants and animals of deserts and the after the grassland there is forest. After the grassland I have written the forest. Okay, forest, it is forest. So desert habitat, right? So under the desert habitat first we have to know the climate of the desert habitat. So the climate of the desert habitat is very hot and dry, right? So the climate of the desert habitat is, the climate of the desert is dry, very dry and hot, and there is very less rainfall or no rainfall sometimes. Okay, so that's why for this due to the low rainfall the deserts are having very little vegetation. Okay, due to the climate deserts are having very little vegetation. Now we have to know the different criteria or features of desert animals and plants. First I will talk about the desert animals. So what is the main desert animal? That is camel. Okay, that is camel. why camels are called as sheep of the desert. These points I have discussed in my last class. Again, I will tell you why camels are called as sheep of the desert. Okay, because they are having large limbs or long legs to keep away their body from the heat of the sand, and some large pads are present on the limbs. Why? Because it helps them to move on the hot and slippery sand. Okay, so that is the first point of the camel. What is the second feature? Second one is that the hump. As you know that the camels are having hump, and in the hump food is stored in the form of fat. That's why we can call it that in the hump fat is stored, right? Third one is that camels drink very large quantity of water, and it can store it in the different part of their body, in some water cells, some muscles, okay? And it can live without drinking water for about 2 weeks, okay? And they expect very less amount of water, very less amount of water through urine, okay? And they can adjust its internal temperature according to the surrounding air by sweating less under the bright sun to maintain the body temperature. So these are the main features of camel, and for these camels are called as sheep of the desert. Camels can survive in that hot, dry condition very easily with the help of the these properties. And another thing is that their eyelashes are very long. Why? Because as they are living in the desert, sand wind may occur. So these long eyelashes will protect their eyes from that sand wind. Okay. Now, beside camel, there are some other animals which can survive in the deserts. Who are they? Some rats, some snakes, but these are very small animals. As you can see, the rats are very small, right? And rats are not having long legs, snakes also. Then how they will be able to survive in the desert? That camels are having long legs, but rats are, as they are chotu, they are very small animals, so they will stay inside the deep burrows in the sand in during the daytime. Why? Because at the day the heat is quite more. That's why they will stay away from the intense heat during the day. Okay, they will stay away from the intense heat during the day. And where they will stay? They will stay in the deep burrows, or they will stay in burrows deep in the sand. Okay, and when these animals will come out? These animals will come out during the night. Okay, these animals will come out only during the night when it is cooler. As you know, the climate of the desert, that during the day it is very hot, but at the night time it is cool. That's why these type of animals that living in the desert, they are inactive during the daytime and become active during the night. Why? This is just to prevent loss of water. estivation and hibernation. Okay, that certain animals hide themselves in the burrows with that they can sleep for 8 to 9 months in a year. These type of properties are called as hibernation and estivation. Hibernation means those who can cannot withstand the cold environment, they will be inside that burrows. These properties called as hibernation, and those who cannot withstand the hot temperature, these properties called as estivation. Okay, this is for your higher classes. I am just telling you the terms. Okay, now so these are the different criteria of desert animals. Now we have to know, yes, those who can sleep during the whole winter. Okay, so that means they cannot withstand the cold temperature, that's why. Okay, now another part is that we have to know the desert plants. Desert plants, the plants which can be found in the this type of climate, these are called as xerophytes. Okay, these are called as xerophytes. Abir and Saswat. Abir and Saswat. Stop typing. So another is that in case of desert plant, their stomata, as you know, the stomata, with the help of that stomata which is present on the leaves, the transpiration is taking place, and the stomata will be in the opening, will be inside part. Why? Because with the help of that stomata, this is called as sunken stomata, they will be able to reduce the rate of transpiration. And the another part is that the thick cuticle found on the stem and leaves preventing the loss of water. Okay, so these are the main characteristics of desert plants. Now I will discuss about the mountain regions. First, if I consider the climate of mountain region, what is the climate of mountain region? What is the climate of mountain region? It is very cold and windy. Right? It is very cold and windy, and during the winter, snowfall may occur. Right? So, and rainy is often. Okay, yes. Abir. Stop, what are you doing? So, in the mountain region, it is very cold and windy, and in some areas, snowfall may occur or may take place in the winter. Okay, and there are a large variety of plants and animals living in the mountain region. So now, if I consider the mountain trees, if you have visited the mountain once, or you can see that in the mountain, these type of cone shaped trees can be found, right? These can be called as conifers. So the in the mountain trees or plants, these are cone shaped. Okay, so the plants, the trees adapted to such type of cold snowy climate, they are having cone shape and have sloping branches. These type of sloping branches can be found in these type of mountain trees, and they are having needle like leaves. Why these type of sloping branches and needle like leaves are required? Because that these adaptation help the rainwater and snow to slide off easily. Just imagine that in the mountain region, during the winter snowfall will occur. So when the snow will fall on that region, it will fall off very easily for that sloping part. Okay, that's why name of this tree. These type of trees are pine, oak, fir. These are called as conifers. Okay, those who are having these type of cone shaped trees. Clear? Now, this is the main criteria of plants which are surviving in the mountain region. Okay, and there could be trees with shapes very different from these that are also present. And except this shape, there are different type of trees which are having different shapes can be found in the mountain region. Okay, now if I consider the animals of mountain region, then what criteria they will have? That the animals which are living in the mountain region, they are usually white or light colored. The animals which are living in the mountain region, usually they are whitish or light in color. Why? Because it helps them to camouflage with the surroundings, and this also helps them in thermal regulation. That means with that, when the snow will fall over the mountain, it will look whitish type, it will appear whitish, but the animals which are staying in the mountains, if they will show that whitish type of color, they can hide themselves inside that region. Okay, that property is called as camouflage. Okay, so the animals in these regions are usually whitish or light color, and this helps them to camouflage with the surroundings, and it also helps them in the thermal regulation. That means they're maintaining the body temperature. Another important part is that they have thick skin. They have thick skin or fur to protect their body from the cold. They are having thick skin or fur to protect their body from the cold. As in the winter, we wear so many dresses so that we can keep our body warm. And the animals which are living in the mountain, snowy mountain, their body is adapted already with the covering of the thick and fur. We are not providing them sweater, right? That's why they have modified their body. They have made this type of fur so that they can cover their body and protect their body from the cold temperature. Clear? So here we will get to know some examples. What are they? Yak, snow leopard, goat. These type of animals can be found in the mountain area. So now if I consider the yaks, yaks are having long hair to keep their body warm. Okay, the diagram is also present in your book. You can see it from the book. So the yaks are having long hair to keep their body warm. Now, snow leopard has thick fur again on its body, on its whole body, not only on the body. It is that covering or thick fur is also present on their feet and toes. Okay, why? Why it is present on the feet and toes also? Because this protects its feet from the cold. Because we are not providing them shoes also, socks also, right? That's why how they will be able to walk on the ice? That's why they have made this type of covering on their feet and toes, and it is protecting their feet from the cold. Okay, it is protecting their body from the cold when it walks on the snow. They need to walk on the snow in search of the food. That's why they need a covering on their feet and toes, which is helping them to walk on the snow. And another one is mountain goat. And these goats are, as their name suggests, mountain goat. That means these goats can be found on the mountain region. So mountain goats also having strong hooves for running up. Okay, up the animals and plants of the mountain region. So today I am completing the desert region, desert habitat and mountain habitat. After finishing that chapter, I will help you to write some question answers from this chapter. Okay, inside question answer. First, let me finish the chapter. After that, I will provide you that part. So, in my next class, I will discuss about the grassland and some ocean part. So, up to that portion, understood everyone? Any problem?